So today I wanted to discuss about daily dialysis. So what is an op-amp and what are the modes of an op-amp, I will be telling you. So first, I'm using the subject here. Linear dialysis applications. So before going to the modes of an op-amp, first of all, we will be knowing what is an IC. Here, IC is nothing but integrated circuit. So as you already know that, what is an integrated circuit? Integrated circuit is nothing but it is a miniature circuit where all the active and passive components are all fabricated in a single crystal chip of silicon. So there will be all the active and passive components will be irreparably joined together on a single crystal chip of silicon. So that is nothing but IC. So in an IC we have two types. So analog ICs as well as digital ICs. So analog ICs can also be called as linear ICs, where we will learn linear IC subject and those ICs, whatever we are going to use in this respective subject. So those applications also we will be learning with respect to the ICs. So here coming to the linear ICs, we have in this 741 IC we will be learning, and then 555 timer, then 723 IC. And then 7 8 6, 7 9 8 6, and 5 6 5. So here 741 IC, this is nothing but an op-amp IC. Op-amp is nothing but operational amplifier. What is that? I will tell you. And the 555 IC is nothing but a timer IC here. And the 723 voltage IC is voltage regulator. And coming to the 7 8 6, this is also a voltage regulator, but this is a pre-terminal IC, positive voltage regulator. And this is a 7 9 8 6, is a negative voltage regulator. And this is nothing but phase lock load. So these are all ICs we will be learning in this subject. So here, coming to the regulator, it gives a constant output voltage. So where here positive voltage, it gives a positive voltage as an output, and here negative voltage as an output. So regulator, in this regulator, these are the pre-terminal voltage regulators, and this is one of the regulator where we can use the 14-pin regulator. So here, this will give the constant output voltage, and this is nothing but a phase lock loop. And coming to the op-amp, we will be mainly focusing on the 741 op-amp now. And we will be learning the modes of operation. What is nothing but an operational amplifier, I will be coming from there. So first of all, what is an amplifier here? Amplifier is nothing but which sends the signal. So which sends the big signal is nothing but an amplifier. So op-amp, that is nothing but operational. So previously we used to use the analog computers. So in analog computers, what it does? It does the addition, subtraction, multiplication and all mathematical operations it does. So in this op-amp also, as we are using the linear IC, that is 741. So in an IC, the size has been reduced, as well as it is going to perform the multiple mathematical operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, differentiation, integration and all such mathematical operations. That's why the name is given as operational amplifier. And this operational amplifier was invented by Robert J. Wittler. And here it consists of 8-pin terminal, 10-pin terminal, 14-pin terminal. So these pin terminals are differentiated depending upon the packages. So as I already told you that in an integrated circuit, all the active and passive components will be fabricated on a particular single crystal chip of silicon. So in that particular IC, when we are fabricating and giving, as we are taking the output from the production unit, so the size of an IC will be very small because, and the cost is also very small because these ICs will be produced in a batch production process. This will be in a batch production process. And what is nothing but the package is nothing but we will be giving the protection to the particular fabricated IC. So package is nothing but a covering. We can say that it is a protection and it is a covering to the respective IC. So these packages are of three types. We can use metal can package. We can use flat package. And also we can use dwell in that package. Mostly in practical cases, as we are used in laboratory, we will be using most probably dwell in that packages. These flat packages and metal can packages are used for different applications such as military applications, airborne applications, etc. So these will be the packages here. So now coming to the main topic here, operational amplifier. As I told you, the definition of the operational amplifier, it amplifies operational amplifier, which amplifies the difference between the two signals. This operational amplifier is also called as, we can say that, differential amplifier. Differential, the name indicates difference. So what difference? As operational amplifier has two input terminals, mainly, I'll be coming to the topic now. So it has, it is, this symbol is represented just like a triangle, and it has two input terminals and one output terminal. Two inputs, input 1 and input 2, and it has the two power supply terminals, positive supply and negative supply. So let me take the 8-pin IC terminal here first. So 741 IC, so let me point out the terminals. 4th pin, 5th pin, 6th pin, 7th pin, 8th pin. Now I will be discussing here. First pin gives the offset null and second pin gives the inverting input terminal, and third pin gives the non-inverting input terminal, and fourth pin will be negative supply, and 7th pin will be positive supply, 6th pin will be output terminal. And coming to the 5th one, this is also offset null. And coming to the 8th terminal, no connection. That is, we can call it as, that will be left idle. So, out of these 5 pins, we will be making use of 5 pins. It is just, the symbol of the op-amp is represented just like a triangle here. So, inverting input terminal represented by a negative side. So, here we will be representing the second terminal. And plus symbol, which is nothing but a non-inverting input, which is given to the third terminal. And output terminal will be taken at the sixth terminal. Seventh one will be the positive supply, as I have mentioned here. And fourth terminal will be given as negative supply. That is the fourth, 741. So, here mainly, what is this inverting input terminal and what is this non-inverting input terminal? We have to know. So, when these modes, we have the three modes of the op-amp. First mode of operation is inverting mode of operation. Modes of operation. Inverting mode. Non-inverting mode. And third one is different. Different mode of amplifier, non-inverting mode, differential amplifier. So coming to the inverting mode of amplifier, before going to the inverting mode, we have to know what is nothing but inverting amplifier first. So what is nothing but inverting amplifier means, the definition itself says that operational amplifier is nothing but a differential amplifier which amplifies the difference between two input signals. So as I have mentioned here, two input terminals are there. The difference between the two input terminals is represented as Vd. So therefore, I can represent it as Vd is equals to, let me indicate this inverting input terminal as, inverting input terminal as V1 and non-inverting input terminal as V2. Therefore, the difference between two input signals is nothing but Vd is equals to V1 minus V2. Therefore, if you want to take the output voltage V0, so output will amplify the difference between the two input terminals, that is V1 minus V2, Vd, we can represent it as differential voltage. So this is nothing but a Vd. So when it is said to be in an inverting amplifier, when it is said to be inverting amplifier and when it is said to be non-inverting amplifier, we have to know. So two modes will be there. So when you are applying the power supply to the inverting input terminal, that is second pin, and for this third pin, when we are grounding, it means that we are not going to give any supply to this non-inverting input terminal, then it is said to be working in inverting mode. So this is the output. So it means that we are applying the input at the inverting terminal of the op amp and non-inverting terminal is grounded. So how can we define this one? So here, as we are applying the input terminal to the inverting terminal of the op amp by keeping the non-inverting terminal grounded, that is nothing but the inverting amplifier. So this is, when it is in the inverting amplifier mode, we can go to the inverting mode of operation. And coming to the non-inverting mode of operation, reverse to this, just what we have to do here. So just we have to ground the inverting terminal, whereas the non-inverting terminal will be given to the power supply. So here, how do we do it? So input means what we are going to do. First, suppose amplifier, the definition itself says that it strengthens the signal. So let us take a signal here. So I am taking a sinusoidal wave here, which gives the time period, voltage V input. So what it does now, as we are using the op amp, this should amplify the signal. So how it will be amplified? As it is in an inverting mode, we will be getting the name indicates the inversion. So we will be getting the output as an inversion of the input. So here you can say that output 180 degrees phase shift will be there. And coming to the non-inverting mode here, similarly, as we are taking the input wave, sinusoidal signal, and non-inverting, so there is no inversion between the input and output. So here you will be getting 0 degrees phase shift. This is a 0 degrees phase shift. So this is the inverting mode. When you are using the non-inverting amplifier, so that will work under non-inverting mode of amplification. Non-inverting mode amplifier. And coming to the differential mode, so here, as I told you already that it amplifies the difference between the two input signals. Therefore, that is nothing but the differential mode. So let us see one by one what is nothing but inverting mode, non-inverting mode and differential mode clearly. Now coming to the modes of operation. First mode is inverting mode. Now, before coming to the inverting mode, just I have explained you just now, when you are taking input to the power supply to the inverting input terminal by putting non-inverting terminal grounded. One more point you have to note down is, when you are using in the inverting amplifier, we have normally two modes, that is open loop mode, closed loop mode. So what is nothing but open loop and mode and closed loop mode? So coming to the open loop mode, we are not going to use any feedback in the open loop mode. And coming to the closed loop mode, there will be a feedback. So it means that what is nothing but feedback? Feedback is nothing but connecting from output to input. So in this case, generally I explain you that when it is said to be inverting amplifier and when it is said to be non-inverting amplifier. Now, when it is in an inverting mode of operation, so we have to use it in closed loop mode. So in open loop mode, when we are not using the feedback, so we can say that this is acting as a open loop mode. So what happens when it is in open loop mode is output level reaches to saturation levels. So what is nothing but saturation levels? Saturation levels are nothing but op amp voltage range. So how much voltage it can amplify. So the range of the op amp is, plus or minus 5 volts to plus or minus 22 volts. So saturation levels means, so it can reach up to plus or minus 5 volts to plus or minus 22 volts. This is the maximum level which is there. So this is nothing but we can consider that as a saturation level. So when you don't give any feedback, output reaches to the saturation levels. So when you use the closed loop mode, so the utility of an op amp and the stability of an op amp will be increased, as well as the output does not reach the saturation levels. It avoids the output going into the saturation levels. So it means that when you are using the inverting mode, let me take here one more circuit. So with the help of a resistor, because we have to find out the gain of the knockout. Just now I told you that activity of an op-amp will be increased and the stability will be increased. So I have to take the resistance. So this is the R1 resistor. So here I am using the feedback. So I am representing it as RF feedback resistance. And this is an output voltage V0. And 7 plus VCC. 4. Then minus VCC. So this is an inverting input terminal and this is a non-inverting input terminal, second pin and third pin. So here this is node A and here what is it, what happens, this in an inverting mode of amplifier, I am using the closed loop here, that is I have used the negative feedback at this respective terminal. So we have to find, main aim of this one is to find the gain of an op-amp. So what is the gain of an op-amp here? Let me take here. So what is the nodal voltage at this respective terminal? It means that the current flowing across this op-amp will be I1 and current flowing across this feedback resistance will be IF. So at respect to this node A, I can write the KCL loop equation, that is Kirchhoff's current law. What is nothing but Kirchhoff's current law? Incoming currents equals to outgoing currents, or else total sum of currents equals to 0 I can take. So it means that incoming currents to this node are I1 and IF. Therefore, I can take I1 plus IF is equals to 0. So that means I1 is equals to minus IF I can take here. So what is nothing but I1? I1 is with respect to the input voltage. So that is nothing but I can take V is equals to IR according to the Ohm's law, you all know already. So therefore, VI by R1, which is nothing but I1. And coming to the IF, IF is equals to V0 by RF. Therefore, V0 by RF minus. So this implies V0 by VI is equals to minus RF by R1. As we are using the negative feedback here, so I will be representing gain as ACL, that is closed loop gain is equals to minus RF by R1. So this is a closed loop gain of the inverting mode of amplifier. Thank you.